Hello friends, welcome to this lecture series in MSc Mathematics Paper 1 course of Algebra. I am your instructor Mandar, and we'll be discussing the topics which is given in the syllabus of Paper 1 Algebra of MSc Mathematics Part 1. Now in the syllabus you have two sections, Section 1 and Section 2. Of which we'll be beginning with section 2 first, and in section 2 we'll be dealing with the unit 1. As you can see, the topics which I have just written down here, which are from the syllabus, the unit 1 consists of topics like group theory, basically definition of groups, various examples, definition of a subgroup, its examples, then what kind of groups are called as cyclic groups. We'll be also doing Lagrange's theorem, then normal subgroups. We'll be also dealing with groups like permutation groups, diagonal groups, matrix groups, and we'll be dealing with group homomorphisms, then quotient groups, direct product of groups, homomorphism, isomorphism theorems, automorphism, inner automorphisms. Then finally we'll be dealing with the structure theorem of finite abelian groups, of course the statement only, and most important will be some applications. So that is what we are going to do in this unit 1. Now I'll be assuming that we all are aware of the basic fundamentals related to set theory. That means, what is a set, what do you mean by a subset, then power set, what do you mean by cardinality of a set, and Cartesian product of two sets, etc. Also we should be aware of the basic fundamentals related to relations and functions. That means what is a function, how is it defined, etc. So we'll be assuming these things, and based on this we'll be proceeding ahead. So in this first session we'll be revising one more concept before we enter into group theory, which is called as a binary operation. Let G be any set, and we know that the Cartesian product of this G with itself, G cross G, is defined as elements, pair of elements A comma B, where A and B both belong to G. We define a function f from this Cartesian product of G cross G to the set G itself. Such kind of function which takes elements from G cross G to G itself, that is from the Cartesian product of a set to itself, then such kind of function we call as a binary operation on G. Now though I have written here F, in general we will be denoting this by, say for example, an asterisk symbol. This is to generalize that this star can be called as a binary function from G cross G. Means a pair AB which belongs to G is mapped to an element C which also belongs to G. This is what is called as a binary operation. Let us see some examples. The theory is easy to understand. Let us see some examples. If I have a function from n cross n to n, and I define the function to be plus, and two natural numbers, okay, I define the function to be AB goes to A plus B. So we know that if A and B are two natural numbers, then A plus B is also a natural number. So here plus is called as a binary operation. Similarly, if I define say dot from the set of say integers, Cartesian product of integers to z cross z to z, and I define this dot binary operation such that AB goes to A into B. And we know again if A and B are integers, then the product AB is also an integer. We can extend this to general kind of thing. Let us say star, and this is a binary operation defined from say real numbers R cross R to R. And I define this star as this AB goes to say A plus B minus AB. Now here plus and minus are our regular arithmetic operators, and this I can write as A star B equal to a plus b minus ab. So this is, the star is called as a binary operation, because we know that sum and difference of and product of any two real numbers is a real number. So this is what we mean by a binary operation. A binary operation is also sometimes called as a binary composition. So the both the words mean the same. And by now you must have realized that why do we call it as an operation and not as a function, because we are doing some kind of operation on the pair of elements which we get from this set on which we define the binary operation. That is some review about binary operations. In the next session we'll be dealing with the definition of group, okay, which we are going to define. Thank you.